It's been a massive activity up until 10 minutes ago here at Piscina Scandoni, the venue for the swimming at the 30th Universiade. Seven finals to be contested. We'll start with the longest distance for women, the 1500 metres freestyle. The first final on night four is the women's 1500 metres freestyle final. Two from the USA, two from Australia, two from Japan, and one each from Poland and Italy. And the Italian is Alicia Tettamanzi, swimming in lane six. So from the bottom of the pool here, we have lane one. Sophie Caldwell going through up to lane eight at the top of your screen. Kobori was the fastest qualifier. Her time this morning, or yesterday in fact, was a second or so ahead of the rest, but not an amazing difference, so everyone here will have a great opportunity to win this. The two in the center, that's Kobori and Johnson. Waka Kobori of Japan, she's an 18-year-old. She's from Nihon University. She goes into this as the top seed. Off the wall she goes at 4:50 and comes out with a little bit of an advantage. Crowd roars because I think the Italian Tettamanzi has slipped into third place. With all of you watching who are possibly casual swimmers and feel as though you're pushing in a decent 50 every now and then at the pool, this is really quick stuff for these young women. 50 meters, no holding back. They'd be zipping past most of us in the pool. Now, there is the danger here that the rest of the field will allow Johnson and Kobori to get away, break away, and make it impossible to catch them. So it's important that Tettamanzi stays there. Sato is on her right. We'll see them in a moment as the two leaders. And now comes Tettamanzi and Sato. Sato up on, in lane seven. Molly Cowell of the USA is in fifth place. There was always this argument that the 1500 meters, well, it was for a long time an argument that women should not be swimming the 1500 meters for a start, and 800 was their limit. But them with a more flexible thinking, realistic thinking, the 1500 was brought into lots of programs. But the arguments really for it not being in the Olympic Games sort of tended to be that people wanted to watch shorter races. It was felt that people did not like to watch a long race. Now, a long race with someone out in front is not a race. What we've got here is a race. So there's interest. There's no doubt there's interest in this. So also a lot of people took the other side and said, let's have a 1500 and not an 800 meters for women. Well, the great news was that in, what was it, April? I think April of this year, the Tokyo schedule came out for the Olympic Games, and included in it was the women's 1500 meters and also the men's 800 meters freestyle. And one other event that was added was the mixed 4x100 medley relay. So some forward thinking there by FINA and Olympic Games officials as we watch them go through 850, and it's still Johnson, but as they look at each other now. She knows that she has Kabori almost on an elastic band. She's staying with her and not slipping back whatsoever. This is a real test for both of these. So there we have 1,500 metres, which will be is fantastic news for the likes of Katie Ledecky, for example, who's the world's greatest long-distance swimmer. Bit of time out at the moment, but off the wall came Kabori, and a very good turn from her. Well, the pace has gone on again from Kabori. She's very smooth. So it's gone up to 2 seconds ahead now of Johnson, and 4.5. So Cowell is closing, which means she's closing quite rapidly on Johnson for the silver medal there. That's a good picture. You see the leader to the left and the third place getter to the right. 4.65 was the gap between first and third at the turn. They go again. 4.9. So Kabori has moved. She's well aware of Carl's presence. Kabori holds that lead. Carl zips off and closes on Johnson. Johnson and Kabori slugged it out in the early stages. With every stroke now, though, Carl is mowing down Johnson. Johnson aware, she can see, looking to her left, head slightly up out of the water and watching as Carl closes. Now she doesn't see her. She's looking exactly the other direction. So too is Carl. They're both looking away. Big kick goes in from Carl. Let's see the difference in the splash as Carl's feet, her kick is more vigorous. Johnson needs to dig it in. She's holding. 14.50 gone. Will this be a change in the last 50 metres? Or will the young Australian hang on? That's Kabori. An all-the-way win. And Johnson and Cowell slug it out over the last 50. Johnson and Cowell. Johnson looks head down, wanting, willing herself to hang on, and she will. She winds it up, touches the wall, and grabs that silver medal. The women's 1500 meters freestyle, the new title holder is Waka Kabori of Japan. Moesha Johnson of Australia was second, and Molly Cowell of the USA third. Time 16 minutes 16.33 for the winner. Well, this promises to be a huge race too. Great Britain has not won a gold medal here. Alicia Wilson is the fastest qualifier by a reasonable margin. Really good start from Emi of Japan. 0.51. She really reacted very, very quickly indeed, and is straight into the butterfly. Emi's breaststroke is exceptional. 37.86 for her in the semi-finals. So we'll see what happens off the wall here as they go into the backstroke. Now, the backstroke for Easton is really hot. Now watch her in lane three. She's wearing the black cap. And this is what she did in the in the semi-finals. Just gained an edge in the backstroke, really hugging her right-hand lane. She'll go to the wall with Wilson alongside of her. So Easton, who was ill at the Nationals in the US and scratched out of everything apart from the 200 IM, where she gave it everything and qualified. And now the breaststroke. So this is where it happens. Easton's breaststroke was a 33. And alongside of her, Wilson did an even faster, 33-13 for her. Really belting it along. Now they're into the freestyle. Easton was huge in the freestyle in the semi-finals, but she's got work to do here. Alicia Wilson holding and extending. Wilson. And Wilson holds. Wilson takes it and does give Great Britain their first gold medal of the swimming. 2:11.35 for Alicia Wilson. She'll be happy with the time. Ella Easton a 2:12.24 and Runa Emai a 2:12.25. All predictions suggest that this will be a battle between Prigoda and Roy. The two swimmers who went 2:09s in the semi-finals. ...200 meters breaststroke for men. It really is a tantalizing race, this. Best of the starts came from Kutasi of Hungary at 0.64 reaction time. He's up in lane 7. The action, though, should be in the center lanes. And already Prigoda, but down here in lane 2, Tiber of the USA, and Tiber turns first. Doesn't matter how good you've been in the semi-finals, the final is what matters, getting there and making an impact. And Tiber is trying to work on Prigoda. Tiber down here in lane 2, Prigoda in lane 4, and now you can see Daniel Roy come up alongside the Russian. Four, five, two. Two Americans, one Russian, have gone through the halfway stage. This is where Prigoda is powerful. Wow, great concentration. What a beaut shot looking across and seeing all the three heads of the leaders going up and down in unison. Where they're going to touch the wall together. Roy and Prigoda and Komenko in lane 3. Prigoda is in the middle of them in lane 4. Komenko in the gray. Komenko challenges. Komenko and Prigoda and Roy. Just outside game's record pace. Prigoda now strong over the last 25. Prigoda from Russia. Prigoda touches first. Komenko gets second and Roy is third. Gold and silver, first and second to the Russian Federation. The USA will get the bronze, so Prigoda, Komenko and Roy, the medalists in the men's 200 meters breaststroke. We've got 7 finals tonight and this is the 4th of them. It's the women's 100 meters backstroke. They get the start signal. And they're underway, and that's that lovely shot of that underwater dolphin kick. The backstrokers, and they break the water legally. not going beyond the distance that they're allowed to. And in lane four, already a slight edge for Burkhoff in lane four. But she's not having it all her own way. They come to that 50. On her inside there, Elise Hahn of the USA is turning well. Hahn does turn first. Burkhoff second. Scalia third. Beautiful turn by the young American Burkhoff. She went into the wall just second, and everything she did on the turn underwater was absolutely perfect. And now she winds into it. She's underneath record time. She's holding out the fast finishing Hahn and gets there in a new games record. Sensational swim, Catherine Burkhoff. A new games record in the women's 100 backstroke final to the winner and the youngest title holder in the pool so far, Catherine Burkhoff. Elise Hahn of the USA second, and Sylvia Scalia of the host nation will take the bronze medal. Men's 200 butterfly, anyone's race. It's a race which, if it's the timing isn't right, you can see, as they sometimes the swimmers have talked about, the piano landing on their shoulders the last 20 meters as the body packs up if you haven't timed it right. But these guys have trained for this. Looks like Carini has responded to the crowd. He had a good reaction time of 0.63. Haramura also quickly away to his right. Coming to the 100 mark, it's a 200 butterfly. BSMX 200 meters butterfly swimmers looking at this and saying, I know what's going through your minds now and your bodies. Because you turn at 100 and you've got to do it all again. And no one's letting up the pressure on you. Lanes 4 and 5. Poprava Kudashev. Kudashev looks to have the edge. His next look will be at the wall. Turns now. Kudashev, Horimura, Carini. Now the big finish from Poprava. Surely, has he got it? Well back at the moment with 25 to go. Kudashev, oh, Poprava is not going to get up there. It's going to be the Russian swimmer who touches first. Kudashev. Terada on his right gets third. Horimura, Japan, 2 and 3. Russian Federation, Alexander Kudashev timed this beautifully to win the men's 200 fly from Horimura and Terada of Japan. The games record for this event, the men's 50 meters backstroke, is held by Zane Waddell of South Africa. Ready. This is it. The men's 50 meters backstroke. Will it be Waddell? Will it be Ress? Or will it be Teresovic? Or will it be someone else from outside of those center three lanes? Green cap of Waddell. Teresovic. Nikolaev as well. Oh, that record might go, but who does it go to? It's Waddell wins it. And Ress. Oh, Waddell and Ress together. Just outside the record. Well, hard to split them, and it's not a bad result when you consider they have swapped that game's record around throughout the meeting. That's confirmed. Waddell and Ress, joint winners of the men's 50 meters backstroke, 24.48. Grigory Teresovic will take the bronze medal from the Russian Federation. These are the nations who will be represented in the 4x200 meters freestyle relay. This will keep everyone noisy and occupied and thrilled, I'm sure, the women's 4x200 meters freestyle relay. Closest to us here in the bottom is Germany, alongside is Japan. And you look up that almost slowish rate from Canada, that's Ainsley McMurray. United States in four. The United States turn first ahead of the Russian Federation, which is way up in lane seven. Argentina, the team just dropping off and moving out of shot now up in lane eight. Italy in six. Possibly see the second swimmers just getting a bit anxious now. They're standing in behind the blocks. There we are. As they watch the US go through first with the Russian Federation second and Italy in third place. Still Rasmus touches there. 50 to go for her. Italy second now. Russian Federation third. The second swimmers for those two nations. Italy was leading and then the Russian Federation had a big strong finish, but it looks as though Scarabelli is going to do this okay. She's really trying to, oh, what a great swim. She looked up almost to see exactly where the American was, Rasmus. She could see a feet splash. Italy in second behind the USA, Russian Federation third. And Gabby DeLouf, what an outstanding swim she's had. Both she and her sister have swum well here for the US in previous relays. Gabby DeLouf, you would expect in her hands that this relay is under no threat. But what will happen on the other side? Mongiaro of Italy, Klavanovic of the Russian Federation. Mongiaro coming in second at the moment from the University of Bergamo. Klavanovic from the Tumen State University. Well, it sounds like the USA call you can hear, but that's being drowned out by this very vocal domestic crowd. And it seems to be working. Mongiaro of Italy is in second place and comfortably in second place now. Gabby DeLouf from the University of Michigan anchoring the USA team to a gold medal. And a very good time too. Oh, very good time. Is it a record? 7:42.08. Wow. USA first, Italy second. And the Russian Federation third. The United States women's team won the final gold medal of this fourth session. The women's 4x200 meters freestyle.